Hello everyone, in this part 4th of limits and derivatives, I'll explain you evaluation of limits involving exponential and logarithmic function. First of all, we will understand the meaning of exponential and the logarithmic function. If we have any function fx is equals to b raised to power x, then this is known as the exponential function with base b, and where b is any real greater than 1. Now, if we have any function in which we have base is 10 raised to power x, then this is known as the common exponential. What is this? This is known as the common exponential. If we will consider about this series 1 plus 1 upon factorial 1 plus 1 upon factorial 2 plus and so on, then always remember this thing, that the sum of this series will create a number which is irrational number between 2 and 3, and the value of this one is given by 2.71828182845905, and this number is represented by E, and this E is known as the Euler's number. What is this? Euler number. And whenever we have any function with base e raised to power x, then this is known as the natural exponential. What is this? This is known as the natural exponential. So this is the basic concept of the exponential function. Now let's start to understand the logarithmic function. For this, look at this thing. If we have m raised to power n is equals to x, then it is known as the exponential form. This is known as the exponential form. This exponential form can be converted in this form: log x base m is equals to n. And this is known as the logarithmic form. So, from exponential form only we can create the logarithmic form. On the basis of this, we can say, if we have any function fx is equals to log x, and the base for this is if e, then this is known as the logarithmic function. In logarithmic function, this base e can be changed. But for our standard form, we will always consider the logarithmic function for which base will remain e. For mathematical calculation, this base is always equals to 10. But in our whole calculation, if we are not representing any base, then the understood meaning of this part is this base is e. Now, this is known as the logarithmic function. There are three rules which are very, very important on the basis of logarithmic function, and which we have to use in question also. What is this? Log m into n. Look at this thing. I am not going to write the base of this thing, but the base of this one is e only. Log m into n is equals to log m plus log n, and then log m upon n is equals to log m minus log n, and the third rule is log m raised to power n is equals to n log m. These three rules are very, very important, which we have to use in question also. One supplementary rule which we have to use so many times: if we are finding log m and the base of this one is also m, then the value of this one is 1. So log m base m is equals to 1. Now, after this explanation, we have to remember two rules. On the basis of that, we will evaluate the limit. What is the first rule? Log x, limit x tends to 0, log 1 plus x base e upon x is equals to 1. And the second rule related to exponential: log x, limit x tends to 0, e raised to power x minus 1 upon x is equals to 1. So first rule is limit x tends to 0, log 1 plus x base e
upon x is equals to 1, and the another rule is limit x tends to 0 e raised to power x minus 1 upon x is equals to 1.
Now let's start to do some questions related to this explanation. Look at this thing. What is the first question? In first question, we have to evaluate the following limits. First question, A part. Limit x tends to 0, log 1 plus 5x upon 3x. Now, according to the rule, whatever this is the multiple of 5, this should be in denominator. So, what we will do, we will make it 5. To make it 5, because 3 is constant, we will take outside. This is log 1 plus 5x. Now, 3 is already there. To make it 5, multiply by 5. And what is this? Divide by 5. So, this is the formation. Now, whatever this constant terms, take it outside. It means this becomes 5 upon 3 log x tends to 0. It means 5x tends to 0 also. It means this becomes limit 5x tends to 0 log 1 plus 5x upon 5x. And this is 1 only. It means this is 5 upon 3 into 1 is equals to 5 upon 3, which is the answer for this part. Now the B part. In this B part, we have to evaluate limit x tends to 0 log 2 plus x minus log 2 upon x. Now look at this thing. Limit x tends to 0 log m minus log n. What is this? Log m upon n. It means this is upon 2 and this is x only. So this becomes limit x tends to 0. And what is this? This is 2 plus x upon 2. Make it separate. It means this becomes log 1 plus x upon 2. And here we have x only. So divide by 2 and multiply by 2. Whatever this multiply by 2, take it outside. It means this 1 upon 2 limit x tends to 0. But here we have the x upon 2. If x tends to 0, it means x upon 2 also tends to 0. Log 1 plus x upon 2, and this is x upon 2. According to the rule, this is 1 only. It means the answer for this one is 1 upon 2. Now, let's start to do the solution of this C part. In this C part, we have to evaluate limit x tends to 0 e raised to power x plus 3 minus e raised to power 3 upon x. Now, limit x tends to 0 e raised to power x into e raised to power 3 minus e raised to power 3 upon x. Take e raised to power 3 common and this becomes limit x tends to 0. What is this? E raised to power x minus 1 upon x. According to the rule, what this becomes? This is 1 only. It means the answer is e raised to power 3. Now, in this D part, we have to evaluate limit x tends to 0 log b plus x minus log b minus x upon x. Now, to do this part, we will take first of all b common from here. It means once we will take the b common, it means this become log b into 1 plus x upon b, and same part from here, log b common. What is this? 1 minus x upon b upon x only. Now we know very well log m into n. What is this? Log m plus log n. It means this is log 1 plus x upon b. Here also log m minus log n. It means what this become? 1 minus x upon b. This term cancel out. This log b cancel out. And here limit x tends to 0. Make it separate. Log 1 plus x upon b. And this is upon x only. Here minus log. This is 1 plus
here you can write down minus x upon b, and this is also, we have x, to make it minus, multiply by minus and divide by minus, it means this become positive only. So here this is log x tends to 0, divide by b and multiply by b, it means this is 1 upon b, and here this is log 1 plus x upon b, and denominator x upon b. Here we have already, this is plus sign, 1 upon b, multiply by b and divide by b, and this is log 1 plus minus x upon b, and in this denominator also we will have minus x upon b. So now we will apply the rules. It means what this become, 1 upon b is the constant term, so we will take 1 upon b outside, and when we will take this term 1 upon b outside, what this become, 1 upon b limit x upon b tends to 0 log 1 plus x upon b upon x upon b, and here also 1 upon b common, and here we will write down limit minus x upon b tends to 0 log 1 plus minus x upon b and upon minus x upon b. This is 1, this is also 1, it means 1 upon b plus 1 upon b is equals to 2 upon b, and this is the answer for this part. Now look at this thing, in this e part, in e part we have limit x tends to 0, limit x tends to 0 e raised to power 7 plus x minus sin x minus e raised to power 7 upon x, limit x tends to 0. From this we can write down e raised to power 7 into e raised to power x, e raised to power 7 common, so this become e raised to power x minus 1 upon sin x, and sorry, minus sin x upon x. Now what we are observing, we will make it separate. So e raised to power 7 common, limit x tends to 0 e raised to power x minus 1 upon x minus limit x tends to 0 sin x upon x, and we know very well this is 1 only and this is also 1. So what is the answer? E raised to power 7 minus 1. So on the basis of this explanation, you have to try to solve other questions. Don't forget to give the answer of this question in comment box. Thanks and God bless you.